It's crazy how addiction consumes you, though you are the one consuming the dosage. Whether intravenously, orally, or in this case, visually, pupils dilated wide as the fix is affixed to the mental so bluntly. Caressing every emotion that's led to this depth of low, looking up at where your heart once was, yet understanding clearly how angels fell from glory. And David could compound this crime with spiritually negligent homicide, only to realize after every gaze and click of the mouse, I'm sorry, every time. Why do I allow the torrential downpour of guilt flood my conscience if once the sun shines and the rain clears, this anchor on my heart gets heavier? My prayers feel less heard, and I grow colder as the cloak of Jehovah's mercy feels lifted. What have I done? This is not the repetition that builds up. In fact, this slow, painful, agonizing, blissful death fades my clarity. Soon to be a forgotten memory, this chemical reaction elevating me to a sunken compound is far from the chemistry that bonds, though it pretends to love me so generously. In reality, my actions are only vicariously, blindly emulating a terrorist scheme, strapping a weapon of mass destruction to my heart, praying mournfully before clicking the detonator, knowing the outcome before it even starts. The Apostle Paul's inspired writings to the Corinthians speaks to me personally. Or do you not know that unrighteous people will not inherit God's kingdom? Do not be misled.